World War I was fought not only on land, not only on sea, but also in the air. Today I'd like to show you one of the games which focus on this specific aspect of this war. This is Michel Leviathan Sorbet and this is a new episode of Wojennik TV. Today a game about World War I and about the aerial aspect of this war, because it was a war fought not only on land, not only on sea, but also in the air for the first time in human history. This will be a presentation of a game called Age of Dogfights World War I. This is a game published in 2020 by Forsage Games and designed by Predrag Lazovic and Dragan Lazovic. It is a game for two players, aged 12 or higher, and the time of play will be from 30 to 120 minutes, depending on the scenario and the game mode chosen. This will be a game which will focus on the aerial combats during World War I. We'll get tons of aircraft, both from France, as from Germany and also the United Kingdom, which will enable us to recreate very climatic and epic aerial battles between pilots fighting during the Great War. This is a game which also has an additional expansions which enable you to fly different aircraft from different countries, but today the base game, which as I said earlier has pilots from Germany, France and the United Kingdom. So let's now take a look at the content of the box of Age of Dogfights World War I. Here is Age of Dogfights World War I. As you can see, this is the version 1.2 using the triangle system. The box cover, pretty interesting, which makes you instantly think of World War I because of the aircraft silhouettes on it. On the back side of the box, we can take a closer look at some of the components, so we can see that we will receive several aircrafts in this game from three different nations. We will get the German aircrafts, the French aircrafts and the British aircrafts, including some huge bombers, not only fighters but also bombers and also scouts. You can also take a look at one of the playing boards and at the look at the list of the components. This is a game for two players aged 12 or higher and a time of play with a time of play of about 90 minutes. Let's now take a look inside and let's verify how those components really look. At first we receive the rule book and the instructions, and as you can see this is printed in a big format, which is pretty much the same as that the box size. This is a rule book printed in color, as you can see, with a relatively small font. So there will be quite a lot of rules to master, but as you can see, you have a lot of pictures, a lot of examples of explanation. So this is always a nice addition when we read, when we try to learn new games, if we have not only text but also some pictures which enable you to better understand the mechanics which are explained. So we have firstly an introduction, a description of the components which are inside the game. We have also then the description of how to set up a game, of the different maneuvers and movement rules found in the game, so how to change the altitude, how to change speed, how to move horizontally, vertically, etc. Then we have rules governing armament, shooting, offensive shooting. So again, we have some examples showing you how those different mechanics will work. We have then some other rules concerning takedown, types of damage,
the shooting outcome, defensive shooting, etc. With again some examples, then with explanation of mechanics concerning pilots, weather, because weather will also be a major factor in this game. Finally, we have some other weather aspects such as the sun's position, the clouds. Then we have different game modes. We have the dogfight game mode, we have the reconnaissance game mode, the bombarding game mode, so different types of possible missions, and also a brief explanation of how the expansion works. Finally, we can take a look at the different aircraft which can be found in the expansion, so we can enhance further our game using Austria-Hungary fighters and even bombers. Very pretty yellow ones, look at those, they look gorgeous. We get Russian planes with the huge Sikorsky Ilya Muromets. We have Serbian aircraft, Bulgarian aircraft, American aircraft with the Curtiss and the Packard Lepere, and some Italian aircraft. So if you want to further enhance your playing experience, if you want to play with planes of different nations, you can grab those expansions and further expand this game. At the end of this rule book, you have also a summary showing you the different most important rules. This is also a nice addition. We have three game boards which are quite sturdy, as you can see. They represent the aerial part of the land over which the battles will be fought. As you can see, this is a game board with a triangle grid. This is not very often used in wargaming. I know only of a few games using this system. So this will be quite intriguing and interesting to use. Now we receive in fact three such boards. So some scenarios will be played on smaller boards, some will be played on bigger playing areas consisting of two or even three game maps, so you can increase the playing area depending on the scenario chosen. And then we have a lot of different components which are beneath those game boards and the rulebook. So we have the stands, and we have many of them, because those stands, as you can see, will be used also to show the relative altitude differences between the different aircraft. So we'll have some aircraft at level 4 which will be placed on those stands. Others which will climb even higher will be at level 5, whereas some others will be below them on level 3, on level 2, or on level 1. So you get really a lot of stands. Look at this. So this is the way how this game simulates altitude differences between aircraft. Quite easy and quite intuitive. We get additional elements such as small markers, yellow and red. We have some additional elements. I have absolutely no idea how we'll be using those. Some green markers, additional stickers, as I believe may be used if you grab other stands, maybe due to some expansions, or if you decide just to use your own stands. Markers, this time those will be discs, plastic discs, which can be red or green. We have some bomb markers, because some of the aircrafts will be able to drop those bombs. Again, some additional markers or tokens, maybe representing a plane silhouette. Black markers with the letters B or A. Some dice, 5 of them exactly, 2 standard 6-sided dice and 3 special ones which will be used for maneuvering, as I suppose, and here with some modifiers, a blue and a green die with some additional modifiers used for different parameters. We have some empty small boards, but we have also some which will represent the different aircraft which can be used during the game. So we have, for instance, the British ones with an Erco DH2. And on the second side, we have the Bristol F2 fighter. As you can see, each of those planes has its dedicated board with its speed, its agility, its firepower, the date when it entered service, as I suppose, and with some tracks where some information will be tracked. We have German aircraft, the Fokker, or the Aviatik. Then we have also the French ones, for instance, the Henriot or the Lothar bomber, which, as you can see, has spaces for the bomb markers. We have two player aids, which will be used in order to track some actions or some maybe dogfight events or actions, as you can see, with the possible outcome of the dice rolled, with the probability, which is something which every player of Catan knows very well. The most probable result will be a 7, the least probable will be the 2 or the 12, 3%, 50% of probability. And finally, we have also some damage markers, if I am correct. Those will be indicated in such a way, maybe added to those stands with the planes. We have some additional terrain features which will represent clouds, because in this game we will be tracking altitude, as I said a few moments ago, and we can add also those additional elements to the board, and they will further differentiate the playing area, because it will be possible, for instance, to climb above the clouds to hide from your enemy, or maybe to attack an enemy through the clouds and to surprise him with a surprise maneuver. And finally, we have the planes, which are inside those three boxes. We have the French ones, the German ones, and the British ones. Let's take a look at some of the French planes which are in this game. So those planes, as you can see, are represented by such counters. Those are six-sided counters, as you can see, which have also an information where the guns are located, so in which direction such a play can shoot. Then we have also the silhouette, some additional information, some parameters. Each of those can be placed inside a stand in order to place it onto the playing area. Let's also take a look at some of the German ones. Here are some of the German planes. Let's take also the big one. So here we have some big bombers and also some fighters. We have also a red one, maybe the Red Baron. Very pretty, I like the artwork a lot. It's very aesthetic or very pretty. And finally, we have the box bottom, which, as you can see, is also with a nice depiction of a dogfight of World War I. So this is also a nice addition. And that's it when it comes to the content of the box of Age of Dogfights World War I. Now, I invite you to a very brief conclusion. I'd like to share with you my initial thoughts about what I have found in this interesting box. The content of the box of Age of Dogfights World War I is extremely interesting. Tons of elements, tons of stands, tons of miniatures, tons of aircraft. So this is a game with really a lot of components. I like what I have seen. It's a game in which we will get a lot of chrome, a lot of elements which will enable us to recreate those epic struggles which were fought by pilots during World War I. I really like the fact that we have different levels of elevation in this game, so we receive stands which will enable us to place those planes at different
altitudes. So we will be able to recreate battles fought at different levels, and at the same time we'll also be able to recreate maneuvers which were part of the tactical aspect of dogfighting during World War I. I like the fact that we receive a lot of different aircraft with different stats. They will all be flown differently. Additionally, we have different types of aircraft. We have fighters, we have scouts, we have bombers, which means that we'll have different types of missions to play. And I like it a lot, because such a diversity, such a variety means that games will be played very differently and will be very climatic and very engaging. I like this a lot. I like the way how the rule book was prepared. It's a long rule book with a lot of text, but it seems to be nicely prepared with a lot of examples, and I believe that this will be a book which explains in a very good way how to tackle the game. So I'm very eager to try this game. I'm very eager to start my first game. I'll tell you more about Age of Dogfights World War I during a future review. Up until then, I invite you to take a look at our other videos in English. We have other unboxings and also some reviews. I invite you also to take a look at our Facebook and Instagram accounts. And if you want to become a supporter of Wojennik TV, you can become our patron by taking a look at our Patronite account. This was the unboxing of Age of Dogfights World War I from Forsage Games. Thank you a lot for watching this video, and see you next time.